Christmas a lot. But the Grinch, who lived just north of Hoogle, did not. The Grinch hated Christmas, the whole Christmas season. Now, please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. It could be, perhaps, his shoes were too tight. But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small. But whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the Hoos, staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown as the warm, lighted windows below in their town. For he knew every Hoo down in Hoogle beneath was busy, now hanging a mistletoe wreath. And they were hanging their stockings, he snarled with a sneer. Tomorrow is Christmas, it's practically here. Then he growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming. I must stop some way, find some way for Christmas from coming. For tomorrow he knew, and all the Hoo girls and boys would wake up bright and early, they'd rush for their toys, and then, oh the noise, oh the noise, noise, noise. That's one thing he hated, the noise, noise, noise. Then the Hoos, young and old, would sit down to a feast. And they'd feast, and they'd feast, and they'd feast, and they'd feast. They would feast on Hoo pudding and rare Hoo roast beast, which was something the Grinch couldn't stand in the least. And then they'd do something he'd like least of all. Every Hoo down in Hooville, the tall and the small, would stand close together with Christmas bells ringing. They'd stand hand in hand. And the Hoos would start singing. And they'd sing and they'd sing. And they'd sing, 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 sing. And the more the Grinch thought of this Hoo Christmas sing, the more the Grinch thought, I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop this Christmas from coming. But how? Then he had an idea, an awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. I know just how, what to do, the Grinch laughed in his throat. And he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat. And he chuckled and clucked. What a great Grinchy trick. With this coat and this hat, I look just like Saint Nick. And all I need is a reindeer. The Grinch looked around. But since reindeer are scarce, there was none to be found. That did not stop old Grinch. No, the Grinch simply said, if I can't find a reindeer, make one instead. So he called his dog Max. Then he took some red thread and he tied a big horn on the top of his head. Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshackle sleigh and he hitched up old Max. Then the Grinch said, get up! And the sleigh started down towards the homes where the Hoos lay a snooze in their town. All their windows were dark. Quiet snow filled the air. All the Hoos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care. When he came to the first little house on the square, this is stop number one, the old Grinchy claws hissed. And he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fists. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once for a moment or two. Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue, where the little Hoo stockings all hung in a row. His stockings, he grinned, are the first things to go. Then he slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room, and he took every present, pop guns and bicycles, roller skates, drums, no iPads in those days, eh? Checkerboards, tricycles, popcorn and plums. And he stuffed them in bags. Then the Grinch very nimbly stuffed all the bags one by one up the chimney. And he snuck to the icebox. He took the Hoos feast. He took the Hoos pudding. He took the roast beast. He cleaned out that icebox as quick as a flash. Why? The Grinch even took their last can of Hoo hash. Hoo hash. And he stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. And now, grinned the Grinch, I'll stuff up that tree. and the grease grabbed the tree, and he started to shudder, when he heard a small sound, like a coo of a dove. He turned around fast, and he saw a small loon, little Cindy Loo-hoo, who was not more than two. The Grinch had been caught by this tiny Hugh daughter, who got out of bed for a cup of cold water. She stared at the Grinch and said, "Santa Claus, why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why?" But you know, that old Grinch was so smart and so slick, he thought up a lie, and he thought of it quick. "Why, my sweet little top," the fake Santa Claus lied. "There's a light on this tree that won't light on one side. So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, then I'll bring it back here." And he stood for the child, he patted her head, he got her a drink, and he sent her to bed. Then Cindy Lou Who went to bed with her cup. He went to the chimney and stuffed the tree up. And the last thing he took was the log from their fire. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar. On the walls he left nothing but hooks and some wire. And one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Then he did the same thing with the other Who houses, leaving crumbs much too small for the other Who's mouses. It was a 2:15, and all the Who's still abed, all the Who's still a snooze, when he packed up his sled. Packed it up with the presents, the ribbons, the wrappings, the tags, and the tinsel, the tinsel, the trappings. 3,000 feet up on the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode with his load to the tip-top to dump it. "Pooh, pooh to the Who's," he said. He was a Grinch and he humming. "Yet they're finding out now that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open for a minute or two. Then the Who's down in Whoville will say, 'Boo-hoo!'" "That's a noise," Grinch the Grinch, "that I simply must hear." So he paused. And the Grinch put his hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound rising up over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. But the sound wasn't sad. Why? The sound sounded merry. It couldn't be so, but it was merry, very. He stared down at Whoville. The Grinch popped his eyes, then he shook. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came, somehow or the other. It came just the same. And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. And he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzle was solved. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load to the bright morning light, and he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.